Word on escalating tensions in Ukraine. Michelle Rook is back with more in Markets Now.
Grains ended mixed on Thursday. Darin Newsom, senior market analyst with Barchart, is joining us. And we tried to hold on to some gains on Thursday. And of course, the funds have been really chasing these Black Sea headlines to push that market up recently, haven't they?
Yeah, it really has. And, you know, unfortunately, what it's shown us is, you know, we have not evolved away from the headline driven algorithms. You know, we thought there for a number of years, at least I thought maybe over the last, you know, 5-10 years that we had moved away from this. But this week has proven that simply isn't the case, that still depends on how the headline is fed in, bullish, bearish, whatever, certainly seems to change the flow of trade. And we saw it off and on all throughout the Thursday session. So I think the key to me was on Wednesday with the September Chicago contract gaining 2 cents on December, turning around and losing a penny and a half of that back on Thursday's close, certainly puts the spread right back into bearish territory. So we know the global supply and demand situation, at least short term, has not changed.
Yeah, I was going to ask you, how is this going to impact global wheat flow and exports?
Right now, everything we're seeing is telling us that it hasn't changed. Could it down the road? Absolutely. Because, you know, if anyone thought this was just going to be a short-term situation, that we were going, by the time we got to the end of 2023, it was going to work itself out. You know, Ukraine was going to be back in the game and all this. That was very naive. That just simply wasn't going to happen. But I think when the rockets start falling on the ports again and all of this starts to happen, you know, it gets the market's attentions once again. And then, you know, all the headlines and the chatter come out about how Russia was going to, you know, be dealing with ships that make their way into the Black Sea. Doesn't matter if they're going to Ukrainian ports or Russian ports, they're going to be dealt with. So, you know, I think long term there is still a chance it changes supply and demand. Short term, it just doesn't look like it's going to.
And corn and soybeans setting back on Thursday. And Darin, was that profit taking or hedge pressure?
I think probably a little bit of both. In the corn, it was probably more hedge pressure because this has been a gift. You know, it's rallied 80 some cents or more in the December contract. You know, a lot of folks didn't think they were going to have this opportunity here in late July, early August to get more sales on the books. So it certainly looks like it was more hedge pressure in corn, maybe a little bit of profit taking in beans.
All right. Thanks for joining us, Darin Newsom, senior market analyst with Barchart. That's Markets Now, and we'll have more AgDay coming up.
To get in touch with Darin, send him an email at analysis@darinnewsom.com or give him a call at 402-669-0210.